Hello, this is Victor, I'm here with a new video, and this time I want to talk a little bit about color choices and color composition, and what I've learned in this time that I've been painting miniatures. Because really, the color choice, color composition, can be the difference sometimes from between a good job or bad job, or a painful job versus an easy job. Let me explain a little bit. There are colors that match very well together. There are other colors that are very difficult to work with, and there are colors that are very difficult to combine. And you learn this by experience and also by looking at examples. If you are starting in the painting of miniatures, the first thing I will suggest you is look around, look at examples from other people, and from there see what is working and what is not working. Today we have a lot of miniatures and a lot of paint jobs out there. You need to follow one of them, but I will always suggest that you get some of these jobs as inspirational. They are the very different ways to paint miniatures, from very bright to less bright. I will always suggest look for color paints, or work done out there, and you will see what works together well and what is not working together. Then when you paint this type of miniatures, my main suggestion I will give to you is choose one driving color and then choose two or three supporting colors. And try to especially when you're painting an army, try to fix you to these colors. And then of course you can add other colors for the tails was a complementary, but normally when I'm painting an army, and most of the armies I paint, and here you will see that I have one exception very clearly, that is my Slanish army. But normally what I try to do is go for a driving color, a support color, and then some color that I fix for the details. Let's do, for example, one of my last jobs, that is the Stormcast Eternal. For sure, the driving color is the green. And I will say green is one color that it can be difficult to combine sometimes. Then I choose gold as a support color and as a secondary color, and is the second more predominant color, gold and brown. Golds and browns combine very well, and they are quite neutral. Gold is a color that can combine almost with any other color in the palette. So this is why I choose gold. Always try to, their colors, black, white, gold, they can be combined almost with any other colors. You see, I use gold here. I use gold on this guy to do some of the details, also brown. I use gold on that guy. So gold can go on green, on red, on black, can go on any color. And gold can give this sensation of really a very good thing, or as a very noble color, to something more rusty and more like dark color. So really there are some colors that can be used. Black is another color that can, or grays, dark grays, if you don't like really black, is a color that combines almost with any other thing. White, another color that you can use. You can make it warmer, creamy, and goes very well on reds. You can make your green cooler and then goes well with blues and greens. So also working with the tonality of some colors like white or black can go more warm, can go more cold. Gray is another color that can be warmer or colder, even the browns. Almost all the colors, but there are colors that are really facilitate this job. So as I was explaining, one driving color, green, one support color, gold, another one for the browns, and I try to attach this to fix my palette. Then I just do purple and white to do some other two other details. And from there I try to fix the palette on the army. There you can go, when you start it, I will recommend you go simple. This guy here, the army, my Imperial Guard. Renegade Guard, black and red, and then of course the flesh for the flesh and some metallic. That's all the army is almost only with these colors, with three colors, black, red, and rusted metal. That's all. And you can have a very nice looking army. Okay. You can pop up the details with the highlights. The grenades are more metallic, so I can give you more examples. So if you're starting, I would recommend you to go very basic. This guy here, it's almost not that different from the Imperial Guard. Red, silver, and then white or these creamy colors for some ornaments together with the gold. But you see, I don't have too many colors. Why I put this guy here? This was one thing that I experiment with. I do as well. Show you more examples. I can also show you, for example, my main knights. I didn't follow the official colors for the main knights, but see that one color for the armor, yellow, gold for the details, and red. That's all. Okay, so try to fix your color palette. I think this is the most important thing. And if at the beginning, if you don't know really what colors you want to choose and you are not expertise on color combination, I strongly suggest you that you look around and make you an idea. Then also, the same green, the green can go, you depending how you paint the greens and the type of greens, you can go for very vibrant minty green to a really camo looking like this one. So what I will say, first tip is limit your color palette and try to fix your color palette. If you start adding all the details with different colors, it will look too busy. The miniature will look, you will really, the people will get disoriented. Let's put just one example here. Let's put these two guys that have vibrant colors together. Here, you know where you want to look on the miniature. But here, you get busy. You don't know really what part of the miniature you want to look at. There are too many details, too many things going on, that is difficult for the person to focus on that. It looks cloudy and looks busy and looks like a cloud at the end. This was my intention in that case, but it's just to show you what it looks like. So here if you want to look at the details, you can also pop up the details. You see, you don't need to go to extreme colors to make the details to pop up. In the Grey Knight, you can see all the things that have the Grey Knight, all the different details. But I try to fix my palette to colors that are from the same type of spectrum. Yellow with bone colors, and the reds are on the hot type of colors. One thing that can be challenging also at the beginning is, okay, I'm limiting my color choice, but how I make my details to pop up? How I be sure that my details are visible? And this is one thing that you have to go learning. But the best option is, of course, if you go for something simple like that, a very solid driving color, and then to paint the details, it's going to be easy to pop up the details. Sometimes two details will overlap. Well, in some cases you can maybe, but you will see with the highlights you should be able to make the details to pop up. Also, you can make some differentiation. For example, to know what is my prime, I put this knee protection with golden. These small differentiations can make them look really different because you start changing the balance between what is gold and what is white and what is green. And this is also will also help you to drive who is to make some meters to pop towards the others, because if one suddenly have all imagine this case, if all have the blue yellow and the blue helmet, and then suddenly this one with yellow, this will pop up very easily. I did not add in that case, but it's just to put an examples. So in that case, if all have white shoulders and suddenly this have the shoulders on gold, this will be different from them, from the rest of the unit, and will be much easier for you to distinguish them on the battlefield. So these are concepts that I want to share. And here I go for very basic concepts. Limit your palette to choose one driving color. Sometimes you can choose two driving color if you want to do combination of two. And choose two, maximum three complementary colors to this one. Obsessional, you can do add some others for the details, but I really believe that fixing your palette and understanding that at the beginning, and at the beginning can be very limiting to fix your palette, but I will tell you, limiting the palette in that way will help you in the painting job. Especially in the beginning when we don't have a lot of techniques, and you see the difference when you put too many colors can be really busy and difficult to look at that. So that's all what I want to explain this here. If you want to know more tips and you are interested in more, please let me know. If you have questions or you want to know my opinion on something, don't hesitate. Always open to receive your messages and to give you feedback on anything. And if you have also feedback for me, please don't hesitate to leave the feedback in the comments below. That's all for this video. Please subscribe if you're not subscribed. Thanks a lot for watching and see you again later. Bye.